This conference will now be recorded.
Let's record manual testing. Okay. What is a test case? Why do you need to prepare test cases? What is the purpose of creating test cases? Do we need to create test cases exactly every time?
No.
Then I can say it is a mandatory. Test cases are very, very important. If test cases are not there, and you will miss some scenarios. And test cases will improve your test coverage. Test coverage means, what is a test coverage? A test coverage is, tells you how many test cases are executed in your application and completely you are covering entire functionality of the application. All the requirements you covered completely. So that will give us a confidence you are reaching, you are testing complete requirements. 100% requirements you are testing. That you can ensure with these test cases. That's a test case means. The test case is not there, definitely will miss some requirements. That's the problem with the test cases. If you don't have test cases, and without test cases you are testing, definitely will miss these requirements. So why do you need to ensure that you are not missing any requirements while testing? Ensure that you are covering all the functionality. That means more test coverage. If you need more test coverage, you need a test case. So these are the two points you can explain why you need a test case. And if test case is not there, the new person is coming, how he will understand the functionality? So by seeing a test cases, he can understand what to test. You will have a better idea. So it will be easy for everyone to cope up with the process, to test the functionality of the application completely. If you don't have test cases, you are not going to complete requirements are not going to be tested thoroughly. Thorough testing is not possible if you don't have test cases. That's why test cases is mandatory. And some cases, so they'll say very small project and so immediately have to deliver, then okay, we can accept. But if you have, right, if you have a some time, and even agile process also we're creating test cases. Very less time is there, immediately they developed and you want to give some prototype pilot project is there, you don't need to create a test case where their requirements are not stable and you don't need them. You don't need a test cases there. If there is a pilot project and you want to give a demo to the client, but because it will take a lot of changes for every demo after. Such cases, you don't need to create a test cases, but actual project, so is there and requirements are there, everything you have properly, then you can create a test cases. What is meant by this test case first? A test case describes an input, a set of input, action or event, and output will be compared with expected response, compared with expected result. to determine. So what, okay, you are comparing what to do to determine the feature of the application is working correctly or not. You can tell that. So by comparing, you are giving input. For that input, what is the output you are getting? By doing some action, you will get the output, right? So you're typing, then you'll get the output, right? That it is accepting the typed values. And then do some other events. Events means multiple sequence of actions. If you do that sequence of actions, the output that you are getting is customer expectation or not, or the feature is working or not, you can check clearly. That is called a test case. So, and the test case, you can define what to be test, what data to be given, and what actions to be performed to check the actual result against the expected result. So that is the another definition you can take, a test case definition. Okay. And what are the columns are there in the test case document? First test case number, then requirement document number, requirement number, second column. Third column, test case name. What is the name of the test case? Then test data column, precondition, and then test steps or description. This is the very important. And the expected result, description after steps after. Next column is expected result, actual result, then status, pass or fail, remarks, and defect ID. These are the any test case document format. And we'll see, I'll show you the test case document format in a few minutes. Can these test cases are reusable? Okay, you create a test case. So can we reuse them? Yes, you can reuse n number of times. Any environment, you can use same test cases and you can execute them. We have different environments, right? Testing environment, integration, staging, UAT environment, production environment, like that. So many environments you will get. Such kind of environments are supported here. Are these test cases, can we reuse them to execute on those environments? Yes, you can use. Okay, so that's the this test cases means. You can develop the test case for a different types of testing, functional testing. Functional testing is unit test cases, integration test cases, system test cases, regression test cases you can develop, and performance test cases also you can develop, security test cases. You can develop a lot of test cases. That's the test cases can be reusable with the small modifications. What are the characteristics of a good test case? When you call a good test case, okay, you are writing a test cases. Can you say it is a good test case? When you can say it's a good test case? A test case should start with what you are testing. And test case should be independent. The most important first point, the test case should catch the bugs, the defects. If you're executing a test case, there is a bug in that area, your test case should catch that bug. If it is not catching the bug, then your test case is not a good test case. The bug is there, but still your test case is not catching. That means you have to improve your test case designing. You have to modify your test cases writing process. So write properly to catch each and every bug that is there in the application. For that, you have to think broader perspective. You have to think positive, negative cases and different combinations. Then your bug will be catch. So you can catch the bug by thinking different ways. Don't think in one way. So different Testing means a broader perspective. All the open paths. You have to open different alternative paths. How many ways you can do testing? Just think. How many ways you can use this application? You try it. That's the testing. Testing means not to just one path. But testing is so many paths, so many ways, so many alternative ways. You need to test it. That's what I'm saying. Positive, negative, create a number of negative cases, and there your developer will make mistakes. Then you will get a bug. Obviously, as a tester, what we need, you need to find the bugs. That's important. If the developer write a proper code, it's okay. The developer hasn't met all the requirements, he didn't include all the requirements properly, not implemented all the requirements. And if you are not testing properly, you cannot catch the bugs. If you want to test it properly, write it down. All the scenarios, all the cases, all the possible inputs, and write it in the document. That's the test case document. First foremost characteristics of your good test case is it should catch the bug. The first and foremost point you need to tell. How can you say your test case is good if they ask you? You need to tell it should catch the bug. And test case should be uniform and it should be independent. It should not be a duplicate. That's a good test case characteristics. Are there any issues to be considered? Yes, there are some issues. So all the test cases should be traceable. Each test case you are creating, you are writing, that test case should be traceable. It should be traceable to particular requirement. It should be traceable to particular requirement. Otherwise, there is no mapping. What is the point? Okay, this test case belongs to which requirement? That should be traceable, right? That is a traceability matrix also, we call this requirement traceability matrix. Every requirement has many number of test cases. More than one test case will be there for every requirement. There should not be too many duplicates. First of all, duplicate test case should not be encouraged. You should not write a duplicate test case. Even single duplicate test case also not accepted. And old test cases, outdated test cases, you should be cleared from the document. Outdated test cases should not be so present in the test case document. You should clear those outdated test cases. Then only, so you are up to date. That first I told you the points, a few points, testing principles. So these are testing principles. You have to apply here while creating a test cases. Okay. Now, there should not be too many that we discussed already. All test cases should be executable. If you're creating a test cases, that test case should be executable on the application, on the given build. If you're not able to execute, then no use, right? Now, so this is a requirement document, sample document. You can just open, okay, requirement document. And this is the test case template. I'll give you in detail. This is the very less, right? Test case ID, requirement number, column, test case name, then test data. Those are missing here. And precondition, description. This is the description is very important. To what to be tested, what data to be provided, what action to be done, that one. Expect a result always you will get from requirement document. Remember this point. So always you will get from requirement document your test case, their expected result. Requirement document will give you what customer is expecting. What customer is expecting. So that requirements document will provide, and that statement you will write in the expected result column, what customer is expecting. Okay, now let's see, what is a test scenario and test condition? That's very important. Other one, what is a test scenario? Okay. A test scenario and test condition. What is a test scenario? Test case is a test condition. Okay, test case is a test condition. Each condition, one test case you are creating. Yesterday also we did a lot of test cases, right? You're creating each condition is one test case. A test scenario means what? A group of test cases is called a test scenario, right? So test scenario is a group of test cases is called a test scenario. So let me get a better So basically test scenario is a single line. It will give you, by reading that single line, you can understand easily what is meant by a test scenario. So what is meant by a test scenario, and it tells with a single line you can easily catch that. Okay, so with a single line, okay, you can think about all the steps. But test step is individual test case, right? Individual test cases. So that's a test step. Now here, so let's see here. So anywhere we'll get a good points. I think here, okay, this is fine. A test scenario is a possible ways to test an application. For example, testing, you have so many ways like positive testing, negative testing, and using different combination of boundary value analysis, decision table testing. So these are all test scenarios. A test condition is the constraint that you should follow to test an application. One condition. So when username and password are valid, application will move to next page. That's one condition, one test case, right? One test case, that one. A test scenario is many. Entire login scenario is a complete login scenario. So login scenario is both positive and negative test cases will be there. But each positive test case, one test case. A negative, one negative test case, that is another test case. It's not same than first and second. But scenario means the entire thing is called one scenario, login scenario, or set scenario, or cart scenario. So this is the kind of, you know, scenarios means. The scenario can be a single or a group of test cases. So maybe a group of test cases. Are a single also. Okay, so that's a scenario means a test condition can be a piece of functionality or anything you want to verify. So that's a, it's a terms, a goal of test cases, we call this. It is important when time is less. The scenario is important when time is less, and most team members understand the details from one line scenario. So that's a single line login scenario, means everybody can understand. And test case means, so very detailed one. It's an item or event of system that could be verified by one or more test cases. And good test coverage can be achieved by dividing a application in test scenarios, which reduces the complexity. A good test condition ensures the system is bug free. So more test cases you can write to make the application bug free. A test scenario are rather clear, vague, and covers wide range of possibilities. Test condition is a specific to particular attribute to test. So that's test scenario and test condition differences. And we have a test usability test cases. So I have listed out some of the usability test cases in the system testing. So did you remember them? What are the graphical user interface test cases?
Yes, sir.
So what are those?
One is data, phone number.
What is phone number?
What question?
Sir? What are the graphical user interface test cases? That's what my question.
No,
anyway, let me list out one more time. Usability test case are graphical user interface. In the UI, you are seeing application. What you will verify? So that's the usability test cases I'm giving here. And I have given, I listed out a few of them in the system testing execution time, in the test levels. At test levels, I have explained. That's why you have to refer the old topic. But you're not revising. That's a problem. Okay, so first test is verify spelling in each and every screen. You have to verify the spelling mistakes are there or not in the all the pages of the application. Then verify color uniqueness in the screens. Same color is there for all the tabs and font or not, you have to verify. Make sure your page is defined with the proper color or not. You have to check that. That's a color uniqueness you have to check. And then font uniqueness. Verify font uniqueness in every screen. Font should be same in all the pages. Like, so you just open. See that the font, Unique font. So in each tab, this is how you have to look for font uniqueness in each and every page. So that's a very, very important. See that all font is Unique here. This is what we are expecting. Every page, this is the common for across the applications. Any application you are testing, these steps are common. This is not going to change from application to application. It won't change. And font uniqueness, color uniqueness, verify size uniqueness in every screen. The size of the fields should be unique. So if you go to some other website, see that. Can you see this? The images are same font, same size. So that size also should be same or equal to some other. And you can see here the same size. This edit box, same size. And this also same size of the same line ending with the, starting with the same line, ending with the same line. And here also, you see that sign in with the Google Alerts, started with the same line, ending with the same line. The same size also. This, what is the size is there? This size also same. That's the points you need to catch in every page like this. These points is common for every application, not for single application. Size uniqueness, font uniqueness, color uniqueness, any spelling mistakes are there or not, you have to verify. Verify any tab. Any cap means the first letter should start with the cap letter. That's I need cap means. If you have a sentence, the first letter should start with the cap letter. That's a mandatory. And verify alignment. This is the alignment. See that properly aligned.
Yes.
Properly aligned. So that's the alignment means. They should not overlap each other. And then verify name spacing uniqueness in every screen. See that the spacing between the controls is uniqueness. See that between this space is uniqueness space they will provide between all of the controls. So that is the one thing you need to understand. So let's see. So I'll go to. See that? This is the one. Let's open this create new account. This name and everything is properly uniqueness space provided in each and everywhere, and this is called uniqueness of the namespace between each and every control, and that is the crucial for every application when people are developing. Verify the space uniqueness. We have seen a space uniqueness controls. This is the same space between this control and this control. The same space and this control space is same. And also uniqueness, same uniform space they have to provide between controls. See that these are the drop down control. This is the edit box control. And this drop down between that there is a uniqueness space. Uniformity they maintain the space. See that here also. So gender, male, and this is the controls. The radio button is a control. Drop down is a control. Edit box is a control. But every control has a name, surname, mobile number, or email address, first name, new password, and this is the date of birth, day drop down, month drop down, year drop down. This is the female radio button, male radio button, custom radio button, and this is the sign up. Button is a control. That button name is a sign up. There's a labeling. Each control has a labeled, and that labeling is proper or not, you need to check. And then, so grouping all the objects, similar category of elements, you need to group. So like this. See that? General. This is the all general category. These are one group. This is like this, all they categorized. They categorized all these links, and only footer links will be here. This is the categorization of, so everything in the pages should be categorized properly. So that is a very, very important. See that suggested searches. This is the group. Right? And that's a very, very important grouping the objects. Group edges and boundaries. The boundaries means so beginning and maximum end point. So is that clear or not? You need to check. So verify positions of multiple data objects in the screen. The same we have seen, right? Position, how they are positioning these objects. So there is a space properly provided and a grouping between all these different groups. Is it the similar way this space that properly arranged or not? That's a multiple groups. If you have properly organized or not, you need to check. So the next one is scroll bars. Scroll bars is a very, very crucial. See that any web page you go, this is the scroll bar, vertical scroll bar. Can you see this? This is the vertical scroll bar. If you want to see data, you have huge data in the page. The page is not finishing in particular single visible part. You have a bottom side, then you need to provide a scroll bar. If the data is there and you are not providing scroll bars, that's a bug. Make sure you catch these things. Scroll bars is very important. See that we also provided in our blog scroll bars because you have a lot of data. So scroll bars will come. So they're mandatory. And horizontally want to see some data. So these horizontal scroll bars are also there. Right? These scroll bars also very, very important for every piece. So there's some mandatory things these are for every application. So everything you have to check in the application. These are very, very useful test cases. These are all test cases. See that all test case 1, 2, 3, 4, like that we have created. Next to tool tips. So some element you don't know what is that. You want to understand that. Then you should provide a tool tip. So mouse over on something. Mouse over means taking the mouse and putting on that element. So you should provide the tool tip. Maybe you can see here. No, we don't have a tool tips here. So let me show you in the rediff.com. We have a tool tips. See that? When you mouse over, this is a small box is coming bottom side. Can you see that? Live yes. Commentary of the Indian stock market, stock quotes, and business news. When you mouse over on particular element, you will get a tooltip. This is the tool. See that business email when you mouse over, lightning fast business email hosting that you are getting. And then videos, watch videos. That's a tooltip name, enterprise email, online shopping, create a Rediff mail account. I'm also on the sign in element. Every element is different. Right? Already a user, sign in. That's a tooltip that we call tooltip. Make sure the tooltips are displaying properly or not, wherever necessary. So you feel that somewhere this, I cannot understand what is meant by this, what this purpose is, they will provide a tooltip. And they are explaining basically. That's the tooltip you have to check for the each and every page some elements. And verify full forms of shortcuts. You have a shortcuts to verify that any abbreviations are there. For shortcuts, they should provide a full forms. Suppose ASAP means as soon as possible. And so yesterday we have seen what you see is what you get. That is, so people will call W what you see. WY what you get, WYZ. So like that you have the abbreviations. So full forms you have to give. That's a full forms should provide in the application. They should not keep shortcuts. And verify shortcut keys in the keyboard. So shortcuts, for example, you should be able to access your application through keyboard. Are you able to access your application or not? You need to check like a page up, page up, page down. So if you click that, you should get, I'm just pressing the page down key. See, I'm getting that. This is the page up, page down. So I'm able to access from keyboard my application. Are you able to access? That also you need to check. Or so you're pressing the enter key, you're after typing, you're pressing the enter key. Is it taking that enter key functionality by your application? Or you are pressing tab key. So tab is happening in each and every, see that? If you click on go here, so tab, you press the tab. See that it is coming first here, the tab. Second, it is going to password field. Then show link, then forget password, then sign in. So this is the tab is moving at top to bottom or left to right. That is the tab order is proper or not, and are you are able to press the tab key in the keyboard, is it reflecting in the application or not? So are you able to use all the keyboard keys on the application or not? You need to check. That is called accessibility testing. So whether you are able to access your application through keyboard. So these points also you have to cover. Verify all formats and verify help documents. Okay, you are going for some application. You don't know that application. You want to use that application. So where is the help documents? They provided help documents. They provided a short videos how to use that application. So this is another point, very, very, very important. So you are releasing a product to the market, but the people doesn't know, right? Then how can you take that? How can you use that application? You should have some guidelines, some help documents. By seeing that, by reading that help documents, you can access that application. If there is no help documents, how can you do that? How can you use that application? That's why help documents is a very, very important, and helper videos. Some people will see that here also you have some help videos also. They'll put a short videos. See that? This is the short videos. So these are short videos. They will explain how to use this feature. How to find a new job, they'll just explain here. This is the helper documents or helper videos should be created in the application itself, so that the new persons can come and know, they can understand how to use that features. They should explain the application features. Otherwise, a new person, how he will use that application without knowing? That's why help documents is a very, very important concept. Make sure you follow these steps whenever you are testing any application. All these test cases you go. Tab order is proper or not? Help documents are present or not? And shortcut keys from keyboard you are able to access your application or not? So all these test cases you have to execute wherever you are going up a company, you have to apply this. This they won't give in the requirement document. This is a generic test cases for any application.
This conference will now be recorded.
Any questions?
I think I'm good, sir.
Okay. Next, I'm just giving a few test cases for ATM. ATM is an application, right? ATM is an application. So they developed the software and deployed in the ATM centers. This is software, basically. And that before releasing the software, first we are going to test inside the company. How you will write a test case for ATM. So this is the one. First test case, verify card insertion. Are you inserting a wrong direction? Are you inserting a right direction? So that's the first test case, verify card insertion. Second test case, verify operation with the wrong angle of card insertion. First, insert a card in the correct direction. Then second test case, you try to insert in the wrong direction. So the people can try this also, right? That's the we need to think. We should not think we have to insert only one direction or correct direction only. We should not consider that test case. People who doesn't know how to insert, they can insert in wrong direction also. That's what, as a tester, you have to think of broader perspective, all the people's perspective, you have to think and write the test case. There is a possibility, right? People can insert in wrong direction also. That case also you have to check and verify operation with invalid card insertion. Like invalid card means scratches on the card, track and card, other bank cards, time expired cards. So, okay, they will give every card has a time duration. Time expired cards also you have to check. So those cards you have to check. So these are all different cards you have to check. And those cards, if you act, you know, insert, will it be accepting? Should not accept. So simply it should say your card is expired and cannot process. Verify language selection. You selected a English or Telugu or Tamil, whatever it is. If you select it, so it should display the content in that language. Screen content. Is it displaying like that? That you need to check. Verify pin number entry. You are entering correct pin or wrong pin. So these are different things. Verify operation with the wrong pin. What will happen if you enter wrong pin? Verify operation when pin number is entered three consecutive times incorrectly. What will happen? Your card will be blocked, right? So that's the, we have seen already these test cases there. Verify account type selection. You have a saving account, but you selected a current account. Can you withdraw money? You should not allow. And you have a current account, but you selected a saving account. You should not allow to withdraw, and you should not allow to give any info. So that's the account type also, you try to do that. We have all these options in the screen. Verify operation when wrong account type is selected. I have given already just a context of that. What will happen if you select a wrong account type? Verify withdrawal option selection. Verify amount entry. Verify operation with wrong denomination of amount. Verify withdrawal operation success. Correct amount to correct receipt to able to take cards back. So are able to do withdrawal process properly. A card you are getting back properly. Correct amount you are getting or not. How much amount you entered, that amount it is giving or not. Are you getting the receipt and then balance correctly or not? All this you have to check here. Many test cases here. You have to verify. Verification here also comes. So your operation is success. So withdrawal operation is success. Then what does that mean? Correct amount should return. That's a verification you have to do, right? And a correct receipt it is giving. And you're able to take the card back. So this is the kind of test cases you need to see that. If your withdrawal operation is success means. And test case title. So verify operation when the amount for withdrawal is less than possible. When the amount for withdrawal is less than possible, then it should allow, right? Withdrawal, for example, I have 10,000, I'm withdrawing 5,000, it should accept that 5,000 should give it to me. Then next test case, verify with withdrawal amount more than the amount you have in the your account. That's a one test case. Verify the limit per day. So for example, you have a limit maximum 1 lakh per day. You can withdraw the from the ATM. You are trying more than that. It should not allow. If you are trying less than within that 1 lakh limit, it should allow to withdraw number of times. But again, the number of limits is there. Number of times you withdraw, the limit also will be there. Verify operation when network has a problem. You have a network problem in the ATM center. Then also it should give a sufficient message. Verify operation when ATM is lack of amount. ATM center doesn't have money. I think we have seen many times like this in the ATM centers. So insufficient amount in the ATM center, out of order. These messages you used to see in ATM centers in India. So these are all messages, are they giving properly? User friendly, right? So if there is no money and it's not giving a message, and how the user will understand? And you will understand, okay, I entered my money is not coming and nothing is showing, then how will you understand that? So that's why you should be very clear on these messages displaying, also very, very important. Okay. And then next, verify operation when current transaction is greater than number of transactions limit per day. We discussed that number of transactions per day. Verify cancel button after insertion of card. You insert a card, click immediately cancel. The card should come out. Verify cancel after language selection. Another test case. Verify cancel after PIN entry. Verify cancel after account type selection. You go till that account page and you select the account, then click cancel. Verify cancel after amount entry. So these are all the different test cases. You can write a lot of test cases here, right? And sometimes you will ask, okay, you entered correct amount and you withdrawn the amount, then it will ask, do you want a receipt? There are two conditions there. Either you can say yes or you can say no also. Two conditions there, right? Yes condition, no condition, both you can take. Yes means you should get the receipt. No means you won't get the receipt. That both you need to test. That's the testing means. You should not leave in single condition also. So that's what the testing means, how you'll write the test cases. I'm giving all the test cases, how to write all possible, everything possible condition you have to write. Now, that's the ATM test cases. You just try it yourself without seeing, or read once and you try to read, but you know how to use the ATM. And you can think of all the test cases without seeing also, you can write that. First, any object, let them give. First, you should understand the purpose of that object. We should know what is the functionality of that object. You should understand that first. Why you will use that? That you should know. Can you take up this test case? You write a test case for Lyft. You know, right? Lyft, you know.
Yes.
Can you write the test? For example, you have five floors. Five floors apartment is there, and there is a lift. Write the test case for that. And specifications, they will give maximum 100 cases only. This will 100 or say 500 cases you take. 500 or whatever it is. Some conditions you assume that. Maximum this many people will fit in this, and this many cases. You should not cross more than this number of cases. So Lakshmi, you both take up this, write the test case for the lift. I want to see how you write the test case. These are all activities. Our main tester goal is understanding the requirements, writing the test case. Now you are understanding the lift requirements.
Okay, sir.
The tester will do the same tasks, so same responsibilities will be there for any manual tester. This is the common responsibilities. Okay, you take up that, and then let me give you a few more about computer shutdown. What are all the test cases you can do that? Verify if all the windows are closed when shutting down. Otherwise, it will ask you. Some applications are open. Do you want to continue or you want to close first them? So it will ask you. You try. opening different tabs and browsers, some different windows, try to shut down. It will ask you that question. Is it asking? You should ask that. If it is not asking, that's a bug. So this all tested in the while testing Windows. Okay. And verify shutdown option selection using Alt F4. Alt F4, if you press Alt F4 in the keyboard, are you able to shut down the system or not? You check it. Verify shutdown option using run command. There is a run command, right? So in this, you can see run command will be there. So this is the run command. You can type here and you can do that shutdown operation. So verify shutdown. You can just click on this start button. You will get this the option. You can choose sleep shutdown. So click on this shutdown. Are you able to shut down or not? So these are the options you need to check. And verify shutdown operation when process is running. Verify shutdown operation when power button is off. Even power button off also, it will shut down. So all these combinations you need to take up. Okay. So like this, you can write a washing machine test case also. I am giving here. You just go through this. So I need to explain again. Okay. And tomorrow we'll see how to write the test cases.